Hello once again, and welcome back to the Kentucky Trip. We left off on our all-nighter that we started on day 5. When it became day, we just did more CNO and TP rail fanning, and that was really all we did the rest of the time. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. The first train was at midnight, and it was NS-174, a manifest from Macon, Georgia to Elkhart, Indiana, with NS-8101, the Central of Georgia Heritage Unit, trailing third. We tried chasing it north, but were notified of NS-179 getting into Somerset, so we raced back to Burnside and caught it there, with NS-1071, the Jersey Central Heritage Unit, trailing second. The next train we see is NS-188 with the solo EMD SD-70As working the sidings at Burnside, dropping some of their train. While 188 was still working, NS-44R showed up with an NS-ACE leading two C-6Ms, and NS-188's unit pulled up while 44R was passing. Thank you. After about 15 minutes, NS-188 finally gets on the move north to Danville, Kentucky. We went over to a gas station for food, and while we started working our way back, we saw an NS train crossing the Burnside Bridge. So we whipped it around and chased it north to Somerset. Turns out it was NS-61C with an ES-44 leading a dash 9. No C-67 in sight, surprisingly. We tried getting everything we could, but slowly fell asleep at the Burnside Depot. But we got woken up by some NS trains passing overnight. In the morning, we went over to Tateville and saw NS-189 coming south, with a C-6M solo and an ACC on the rear, pushing the train really hard. We then see northbound intermodal 28C with a pair of C6Ms. We then moved to a railroad crossing a few minutes south, where they didn't have a complete set, but there was still a southern signal located there, and we saw NS-18E heading north. We then decided to do some more CNONTP exploring with Ethan, as nothing was running. And it wasn't until 2:30 p.m. that afternoon we saw another train. It was an S-54G with a quad of C-6M rebuilds. We decided to chase it south back to Burnside so we can get back over that way. Here we are pacing it at Eubank. Notice how crispy the C6M leader is. We get back ahead of it again and catch it at a railroad crossing in Science Hill. We decided to stop the chase at Somerset and make our way over to the Burnside Depot after 54G cleared. Our first train at the depot was NS-177 with a trio of C6Ms. The next train was NS-123 out of Decatur, Illinois for Chattanooga, Tennessee, with a C6M rebuild leading a soon-to-be C6M rebuild. The next train was NS-143 out of Elkhart, Indiana, bound for Chattanooga, Tennessee, with a pair of BNSF locomotives. After 143 went by, we went to go grab dinner and chill at the hotel, but then we decided to do an all-nighter again, as we heard about a military train that went down the P&L 2 weeks prior, coming back bound for New Orleans. So we tried waiting for it, and the first train was NS-912, a welded rail train with a solo chivo. The next train we saw was NS-174 working the Burnside sidings.
And that stays in.
We went over to a McDonald's in Somerset for food, then came back to the depot. Our last train before midnight was NS-188 coming out of Burnside Sidings and heading north. I hope you guys enjoyed and stayed tuned for day 7, our last morning in Kentucky and a trip to the Crossroads Park. Anyways, I will see you guys tomorrow. Thanks for watching.